So in the last video, Raman Maharshi was talking about the force of the nature which is running everything. And now Shri Prakasham Pillai is asking, who is the greatest devotee? Right? So he's asking the question of devotion. Who is the perfect devotee? And Raman Maharshi replies, the person who gave himself up to the self is the greatest devotee. And by that he means that the person who doesn't give a place for any kind of thought other than self, right? And the self is here means that nature, that force of nature which is running everything. So he doesn't give any kind of thought other than, he doesn't think about anything other than self, and he's established into that self, right? So he gives himself up to that self. That is the greatest devotee, right? And this is also a very common teaching among all the scriptures in different tradition, right? So in Christianity, I think this is something like, it's not my will but thy will, right? In Taoism, there's something like, only when you live by the Tao, you can feel fully fulfilled, right? In Indian scripture, it is all over the places. Bhagavad Gita is like, the highest is when you establish in the self, right? So this is the same thing that Raman Maharshi is saying, that when somebody gives the personal, the ego part, right? When somebody is giving up that ego part and realize that, okay, there is a force of nature which is taking care of everything and which is also expressing through me, and have surrendered to that particular force, is the greatest devotee, is the highest devotion, is the kind of act of surrender. And this is again more, this is not a public discourse, right? This is not something that Raman Maharshi is telling to a normal people. And the person, Shri Prakasham Pillai, is a fairly advanced practitioner, right? So in a way, this is more like this is something happens at the end of the spirituality, right? That a person is kind of starts surrendering it based on his experience, right? Based on what he has realized, he kind of starts surrendering his personal self to the higher self, right? So it's not something we do in the beginning. It is something more towards the end. And this is also very well, you can see this in the Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita kind of starts with the yoga of action, right? Master your action. Then it goes into the yoga of knowledge. Then it goes into the yoga of meditation. And then it talks about like what the self is. It gives like a big, huge five to six chapter lecture on like what exactly is the self. And then he goes into the yoga of devotion and surrender, right? So it's like more towards the end. Once somebody has realized, it's not some kind of a faith-based devotion that, yeah, there is a God and, the God is almighty and I want to serve and surrender. Not that kind of stuff. It's more like based on somebody's personal experience. Here, Raman Maharshi clearly has that personal experience of what the self is. And then when he realized the self is this, like this force of nature, which is actually creating things like sun and, turning the seed into the tree, then from that standpoint, he sort of, devote his personal self of like thinking about what should I do, what should I not do, all this kind of stuff. Instead of that, he start devoting himself into the force of the nature, which is taking care of everything, right? So it's more like it's not something about blind devotion towards an idea or ideology. It's more like an experiential devotion towards deep realization, I think. So very beautifully, like one who has surrendered himself into the self, right? One who doesn't give any space for any other thought other than self is the greatest devotee. The answer from Maharshi.